President Trump has made it clear through his recent statements and actions that he believes that he can and should be able to rule as the sole decider in our country's system. The past few weeks have seen a battle between the Congress and the President of the United States. And it is clear that in many of Donald Trump's ambitions, in his recent statements about building a wall, about the use of emergency powers, that he is failing to understand that Congress is a co-equal branch of government that has the power to make law, to allocate funds, and that it is the President that executes the laws. And the President's role is really secondary to execute the law and to do what the President is told by Congress. The powers of the President are certainly expanding over time. The Congress has, through a number of pieces of legislation, enabled the growth of that power. One thing that Congress has done is pass an Emergencies Act in the 1970s that Trump might rely on to build the wall. Now, in this case, arguably, Congress has considered allocating the wall funding, and it has decided not to do so. And so, on my view, that takes precedence over any emergency powers the President might claim. And one long-term fix for this is to rewrite the statutes to make it clear what an emergency is and what it isn't, and to make it clear, too, that a President cannot simply lose a legislative fight and then decide to declare an emergency. This distribution of powers is perhaps best articulated in a seminal Supreme Court case involving President Truman. During the Korean War, steel production had slowed due to strikes, and Truman, through an executive order, using what he claimed were emergency powers, tried to take over these mills and stop the strike and get steel production going again. Now, the question before the Supreme Court is, can the President do this? And in the opinion of the Supreme Court, the President's power is limited if the Congress has prohibited him or her from acting. And in that case, the court said, Congress had considered granting the President the power to take over these mills and had declined to do it. And that functions as a prohibition on presidential power, limiting it. Each of those branches has a distinct constitutional role that needs to be respected by the other one. And when the President tries to usurp the lawmaking function of Congress, he disrespects their status as a co-equal branch, and he undermines the separation of powers that are guaranteed in our constitutional system.
Hey, NBC News viewers, thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking on that button down here and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives. Thanks for watching.